He's on.
So here we have the best controller settings for Warzone 2 and Modern Warfare 2. For our button layout, we have tactical flipped. Now this takes the default triggers from aiming and firing and it moves it to your bumpers. Now this is an absolute necessity if you're going to be playing on PlayStation controllers. Just feels a lot better. The triggers seem like the aim isn't as good as it could be, as precise. We're on default stick layout. Controller vibration off. This is going to make your shots extra crispy. You're not going to be feeling any extra vibration while you're firing. Now for sensitivity. Your sensitivity is going to be whatever you're comfortable with. I used to play on a high sensitivity back in like the Jetpack Call of Duties and even a little bit before. But for max precision and accuracy, you're going to want to go as low as possible to get the most amount of aim assist. Now, in my ranked season 2, I was on 5-5 and I was an absolute beam. Took me a while to get used to 6-6, and it's a little bit quicker, but it's still a pretty low, slow sensitivity. Now for the ADS sensitivity modifier multiplier. I like 0.9. I used to be on 0.85. 0.9 seems like the perfect spot to where I can track people if they're jump challenging me around a corner or just being really aggressive. This seems like the best for all weapons, snipers, subs, ARs. Now for the sensitivity multiplier, we have all these at default. And the ADS sight behavior, you're gonna want this on hold so you can instantly get off of ADS. You don't have to press it again to stop ADSing. And for my zoom shared input, like if I'm using a hybrid or a variable zoom on a sniper, that'll be my right stick down for default melee while I'm scoped in. Focus behavior, you're gonna want hold. So you can just hold your left stick in to focus your breath. Now, a lot of people I know, they run automatic sprint. You're gonna want to turn this off so you can be in control of your movements at all times. So you're not sprinting when you need to be quiet and walking, and you can walk, pretty much sneak around the map and get the jump on people. Equipment behavior, we're gonna go hold. A lot of these for toggle aren't really worth it. You're gonna get caught trying to do your actions while you're on toggle. Now for mounting, this is mostly for pubs and Warzone. I like ADS and melee, so it would be L1 and right stick down, so I'm not accidentally mounting on things if I'm getting in a gunfight and I accidentally double tap L1. Now this setting is mostly for Warzone, and it is kind of annoying, but it's going to be interact reload behavior. I have prioritized interact. So what this means is in the Warzone, I can pick everything up just by tapping, but if I want to reload, I have to hold the square button down. And it's the same like this in multiplayer. So you kind of almost feel like you're losing a step or two trying to reload, because it's not instant reload. But in the long run for the Warzone, this is definitely going to be something good. And you're going to catch yourself picking up some weapons off the ground, forgetting to hold. But it's something you definitely get used to, and I highly recommend this. For plate behavior, apply all. You don't want to just apply one plate at a time. Pretty self-explanatory. Now moving on to advanced, this is where the real settings are going to be shown right here. We do play with aim assist. Pretty much, it's a bubble around the hitbox, and that you're going to get massive slowdown. Now, for aim assist type, default precision focusing in Black Ops. At the beginning of Modern Warfare 2, a lot of people were running this Black Ops, but they made a change, and default aim assist is the best. I can 100% guarantee that to you. These other two, they're gonna feel off. It's almost like they're decreased in the amount of ADS aim assist they give. So make sure you're running default and make sure your aim assist is on. Some people I find they don't even have this on. Aim response curve type. So this is how your stick is going to act in game. So standard is very good. I know on Apex I play linear, but for Call of Duty I've been playing on dynamic, I believe, since Modern Warfare 19, and it is really accurate, really snappy. And for the description, it says reverse S curve mapping for fine aim rate control. So this is the setting where you're going to be able to snap almost anybody. Feel really smooth. Great movement throughout the map. For the ADS sensitivity multiplier while you're in focus, I have this just at 1.0. So this will be default ADS sensitivity of that 0.9. Now for transition timing, I like instant. So as soon as I start aiming in, my slowdown of that multiplier is going to turn on. Custom zoom sensitivity, we're going to have this off. This is personal preference here. If you're feeling like it's a little too fast, you can always change that. Now for dead zone inputs, this is very important. I actually just changed my right stick dead zone to 0.04, and it's still a little too low. I have a little bit of stick drift, but I was playing at the default 0.15, and I was pretty good at the default, but changing this down to 0.04 has just completely revamped my game. I snap onto everybody. My aim and my movements just feel so much more responsive. And this right stick is going to be the one you aim with, so this is the one that's really going to matter. Left stick is mostly for your movement, so you're going to want to probably leave this at default if you haven't changed it. You're going to get some stick drift where you're going to be moving when you don't want to be if you have that turned down. Right stick max, right stick, left stick max. This is just for how far it goes to you actually get the turn in. And for the triggers, I have these both turned all the way down. You want instant aiming and firing when you want it. Gyros, I have all the gyros turned off. I don't do gyro aiming. Now for your sprint, tactical sprint behavior, you're going to want toggle. So when you're running, you can, and you quit moving your stick, it'll stop you from moving. And if you double tap, you're going to get the super sprint, the tactical. Auto move forward, I have this turned off. I don't want to be moving when I'm not putting an input on that left stick. And for the tactical sprint behavior, you're going to want single tap sprint. So you kind of save yourself from spamming that left stick all the time. Now these are some new settings I also just changed. I was seeming to mantle on everything. If I was trying to do a jump shot or something, jump over some cover just for a little peek, it was making me mantle all the time. So you're going to want to turn these off. It's going to be grounded mantle, airborne automatic mantle, and automatic ground mantle. Turn all these off. So it's going to be manual mantling, where you'll have to double tap to ensure that that's what you're trying to do, is mantle over those objects. And for invert, slide, and dive behavior, you're going to want this on inverted. So as soon as you press that circle button or your left trigger, your left bumper like I have, it's going to make you dive instantly. Sliding is good, but it's very situational when you would want to do it. Plunging underwater, plunge freely. This is also how you do the Shotzi movement tech, where you can pretty much fly out of the water. I like this more than a lot of the other ones. Auto parachute, you're going to want this off. It is good if you are in a laggy server or something, you might want to turn it on, but off is great for getting your drop spots, getting to the drop spot as fast as possible. I believe this is on by default, but you have sprinting door bash. You're going to want this on so you can just bust through doors at people. And then ledge hang mantle behavior. I have mantle only, so I don't get a delay when I'm hanging off a ledge and you press that stick forward. It's kind of make you kind of pull yourself in, but if you have mantle only, you only have the choice of hanging, aiming your weapon, or climbing through the window, so there's no extra delays. For ADS stick swap, don't swap the sticks during ADS. Alternate control for the backpack in the war zone in DMZ, you're going to want to turn this on. So as soon as I pull out the backpack with the bottom arrow, I use my sticks to navigate that menu. Now for the weapon mount exit, you're going to want this on so you can pretty much pull your back stick back left or right and it's going to pull you out of that mount. This is really effective so you don't have to un-ADS to get out of it. And I have it on medium. I like medium a little bit better. It feels pretty good getting out of those mounts. Depleted ammo weapon switch, you're going to want this on so you're not holding a weapon without ammo. You can switch to your fists or your knife or whatever you have in your pocket. C4 detonation, I don't use it. I don't use C4 at all. These vehicle settings, I got short delay on the recenter. It's all right. Initial position, you're going to want free look so you can get in the vehicle and kind of use your third person to see if there's anybody around. Scoreboard, I got toggle, ping wheel, moderate, double tap danger, moderate. This is all Warzone ping stuff. And I got hold for the last setting. Now these are the best settings, in my opinion. You guys saw my stats, saw my combat record. I have a lot of time put into this game. And this feels the best for me. So there we have it, man. Best controller settings for Modern Warfare 2 and Warzone 2. Got almost 15 plus days played on here. These are my absolute best settings. I don't see myself changing any of these. Maybe you get into your new rank in ranked play. Maybe you go crazy in the Warzone. Warzone ranked when it comes out. But if you guys enjoyed this video and it helped you out in any way, drop a like. Leave a comment. Let me know what settings you had different. Make sure you hit that red subscribe button, man. It's been your boy, Jay Revenge. I'll catch you on the next one, man. Peace.